Start. So today we are going to discuss very important concept of the Vedic mathematics is the Nikilam division. So I will start from the very basic idea. So what kind of a division we can do in the Nikilam division? That is the first question comes in our mind. So the first is, if you have any two digit number, I will take any two digit number, means two digit number, and this will be dividend. Dividend means dividend, okay, and the divisor is only 9, means divisor is 9. So when you have any two digit number and you want to divide with 9, sometime it may be easy for you directly and you want to get, but you will learn the process from the small example, okay. So dividend is two digit number, any two digit number, and divisor is 9, correct. So I will take very small example in the first example. So when you will divide, let us suppose 13 divided by 9. So what you people and we people normally do, we will divide with 13. You have a dividend is 13, divisor is 9, so your quotient will be 1, so remainder is 4. It's very simple, no problem at all. So I will explain the Nikilam division concept with this small example, and I will extend my example in the large cases. So if you have a two digit number 13 and you want to divide with 9, so what you will write? The first thing you must know, the base of 9 is 10, you know that. And there is one more concept, the complement. Complement is the number subtracted from its base. It is the complement. Here complement is 1. Number is 9 and base is 10. If you want to get the complement of 9, that is equal to 1. So what you will write? You will write the both the digit 1 and 3, that is the division, and the base of 9 is 10, so only one zero is there. So you will separate this digit, only one digit I will use for the remainder. So what you will do? You are going to divide with 9. Very interesting, try to understand the concept. So first I will take the complement of 9. Complement of 9 is always 1, so you need not to take again and again. Very simple. Complement of 9 is 1, already we have done. Maybe in this example I am not going, I should not discuss the complement, because always I am taking 9, complement will be 9. So complement will be multiplied with this number and you will put in the next digit, means you will write 1 multiply 1, you will put here, and you will add. When 3 plus 1 you will get 4, and 1 is as it is. So this here is the quotient is 1 and remainder is 9. Here remainder is 4, this is the remainder and this is the quotient. Very simple. I will take one more example, you will understand. Now it's better to take one more example. You have a 34 divisible divided by 9, correct? Another example. So what you will do, because I am dividing with the standard method also, divide by 9. So what you will do? You have a 9 into 3, you have 27, and the remainder is 7. So in the same way, you will write 3 and 4, only one digit you will take the remainder. So the quotient, so complement of 9 is 1. 1 multiply 3 you will put here. So 3 plus 4, 7 and 3. So this is the remainder and this is the quotient. If you understand, just give me the response. If you understand, say yes. If you know, then say no. If you understand, just comment it. You understand or not? If you understand the concept of the Nikilam division, two digit divided by 9, no. Why no? Once again, you will write 3 and 4. The complement of 9 is 1. Student, complement of 9 is 1. 1 multiply 3, you will put this result here, multiplication, the result, 1 multiply 3 is 3, you will write here, and 4 plus 3, you will get remainder 3 as it is. This will be the quotient. Now you understand or not? Understand or not? Yes, good. So now you can extend this example. Very interesting. Now see, I am taking, you can try yourself also. You can take your notebook and pen, pencil. You can try yourself all. Even you can do in your mind also. You need not to take the help of calculator or any pen, pencil. You can do at your end also. So 80 divided by 9. Very simple. So you can check. I am going to write here 8, 0 divided by 9. Complement of 9 is 1. 1 into 8. 8 I will put here. 0 plus 8. 8. Here 8. Remainder is 8 and quotient is. Understand or not? If you understand, say yes. If you understand, say yes, students. Only say why. Need not to write why, yes. You just put why. If you understand, put why. Yes, Tania, good. Good, good, good. Any other response? Yes. Very good, very good. Now, student, I am going to extend this. These examples. Now, more complex. So now 43 divided by 9. If you have it 43 divided by 9. Now this is the another example. You have a 4, 3. Complement of 9 is 1. So 1 multiply 4. Put here 4. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 is the remainder. 4 is the quotient. Very simple. Very good. Very interesting. You have done it. Okay, this is the quotient. Now another example. Now I am going to take 3-digit number. This division may be for easy for you, but when you will take 3-digit number, it is going to be complex with the standard method. So 3-digit number. So participant, I am going to take 3-digit number. So example, the first example that I am going to take, the example is 104 divided by 9. Now, interesting, there is some difference. So see, even you can try yourself first. 104 divided by 9. I will do it step by step. 19. So what you will write here? 14. You will write here 19. You have 5. So quotient is 11, remainder is 5. This is the remainder. Now, so you are dividing with 9. So its base is 10. Complement is 1. Need not to discuss again and again. Very much clear. But 104. You will take only one digit. Because you are taking 9, its base is 10. You have only 10 in the base. So you will take only one digit as a remainder. So divisor is 9. Student, very interesting to see. So complement is 1. 1 multiply 1. 1. Put in the next digit. Put here the whatever the result of multiplication you will put here. Now after that you will add 1 plus 0. You will add these two digits. Addition. Once again, first what you have, the complement of 9 is 1. 1 multiply 1 you have written here. Okay. Now 1 plus 0, result is 1. Correct. So 1 multiply complement 1 you will put here in the next digit. Okay. So 4 plus 1, 5. So 10 plus 1, 11. So this is the remainder. This is the quotient and this is the remainder. You understand or not? If you understand, say why. If you understand, say yes. Good, good, good. You understand. I am going to take one more example. It will be more clear to you. Take one more example. Student, one more example. See, 212 divisible by 9. Okay. So one thing is clear. We are only dividing with 9. So first concept, Nicolum division is used for the 9. I will extend this example also. So see, now, 2, you can divide directly also. No problem. You can check whether our result is correct or not. So 9. when you will divide it, you will 2, 18. So you can check the time I am taking for this. So 3, you have a 2, 9, 3, you will get 3, 27, remainder is 5. So 2, 1, 2, very interesting, 9. Okay, quotient is complement. I'm just explaining, that's why I'm taking time. 1 multiply 2 is 2. So 2 plus 1, 3. 3 multiply 1, 3. 2 plus 3, 5. 21 plus 2, 23. Only addition and multiplication, no subtraction. So this is the remainder and this is the quotient. Understand or not? If you understand, say yes. Student, if you understand, say yes. Good, good. Now, you can try. I'm taking some more example. Now, you can try 104 divided by 9. Divided by 9. Check the answer. Do it. Just answer it. Quotient, quotient. 401. Now, what you will do? 9. Complement is 9. Complement of 9 is 1. 1 multiply 4. 4. You will put here 4. Correct? You will put here 4. 4 plus 0, 4. 4 multiply again 1, 4. So you have a 544. You can check. 401, when you divide with 401 divided by 9, you will get 44 as a quotient and 5 as a remainder. You can verify. You can verify. No, 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 no. 44 and 5. Student, you can check. You can check. Tanya, you can verify. You can verify, you can do it directly. 401 divided by 9. What you will do? What you will do? You will divide with 4. Quotient is 4. 36. 9 into 4, 36. You have 4. 4, 1. Again 4. 36. You have 5. Remainder is 5. And quotient is 44. Student, understand or not? If you understand, say yes. Because I want to go further. Yes, good. Very good. Very good. Now, move it further. So, next example, you can try. It is for you. Try it. Quickly, quickly. Try it quickly. Very quickly. Don't use calculator. Don't use standard method. Very quickly. I got it. Very quickly, 511 divided by 9. I want answer. Hurry up. Yes. Who is the guy? Rajan Kumar. Good. Rajan Kumar. Excellent. Yes. Priyanka Sharma. Correct. Simranjeet. Correct. Tanya. Lankesh, very good, very interesting. 5119, you will separate it. Now divisible by 9, complement is 5, 1 multiply 5, put here 5. Now 5 plus 1, 6, 6 multiply 5, so 6 multiply 1, 6. So you have a 7, or here you have 56. So this is the quotient, this is the remainder. Okay, you can extend for the 4 digit number, student, 4 digit number. 1204 divisible by 9. You can try it. Hurry up. Try it. Here the complement is 1. So what you will write? Now 1 multiply 1. Result is 1. You will write here 1. Correct? So 1 plus 2, 3. 3 multiply 1. Result is 3. You will write the next 2 that. Okay. So 1 plus 2 plus 0. 3. 3 multiply 1 is 3. So 4 plus 3. 7, 0 plus 3, 3, 2 plus 1, 3, 1. This is the quotient, this is the remainder, you can check. Very good, Tanya, you got it. Yes, very good, very interesting. So if even you can check it, you have to check whether our answer is correct or not. It is very interesting to check because 1 will 9. So you have a 3, 0. Standard method is take time. Standard method is take time. 0, now you will multiply with 3, 27, you are getting 3, now put 4 here, so 3, 27, you are getting 7. So check it, remainder, quotient, answer. Correct? I hope you understand. Rahul, Simran, everyone got it. Everyone got it. Everyone got it. It's your test. 1 3 2 0 1 1 3 2 0 1 extend 1 more digit 1 3 2 0 2 1 0 1 divided by 9. Hurry up, do it quickly, very quickly. Same process, no change. Same process, very quickly, hurry up, within seconds. Hurry up, student, hurry up. Very interesting to see your answer. Now, see, very interesting to see this. 1, 3, 2, 1, 0, 1. Only one digit because you are dividing with 9. 9. Complement of 9 is 1. 1 multiply 1, put here. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 multiply 1, here. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 multiply 1, here. So 1 multiply 3, 4, 6 plus 7. 7 multiply 1, put here. So again 0, again 7. 7 multiply 1, 7 here. So 1 plus 7, 8. 7, 7, 6, 4, 1. Very easy. This is the quotient. This is the remainder. Very interesting. Very interesting. Very interesting to see it. Try the Nicklam division. Now, student, there is one challenge. There is a very challenge. The challenge is, if you have a remainder, remainder is equal to, or, because I have not taken such example where remainder is equal to or greater than divisor. So this is interesting to see. When the remainder equal to and greater than divisor, then what you will do? See, I will take the example 36. The second step you will do yourself. I'm just going to discuss one example. When you will divide with 9, it's very easy. For you, it is very easy. I want to try with the Nicklam division. Because when you will extend this example in the large number, then you must understand the challenge and how you will remove this challenge. So you have a 3 and 6. Very easy. So you will, what is the complement of 9? Complement of 9 is 1. So 1 multiply 3, you will put 3 here. So 6 plus 3, you have a 9. And you have a 3 here. So student, this is not a remainder and this is not a quotient. Because your remainder is equal to the divisor. You know that your remainder will, should be, must be always less than the divisor. You know this basic condition. And the condition is applied here also. So what you will do? You will divide the divisor again with the remainder. So when you will divide 9 with 9, it's very easy. You can do it in your mind also. When you will divide 9 with 9, so you are getting a remainder 0. So what will be the quotient? Quotient will be 1. Already 1, 3 quotient is there, 1 more quotient. So you have a 0 remainder and 4 is the quotient. So you can check 36, 9, 4, 36, 0. 4 is the quotient and 0 is the remainder. This is the remainder, 4 is the... If you understand, say yes. If you understand, say yes, because I want to give one more example for you. Sir, explain again. Okay, no problem. Student, very easy. Because why I am not taking 9 as a remainder? Because 9 is equal to 9. The example when remainder is equal to the divisor. So what you will do? You again divide 9, whatever the divisor, with the remainder. Now remainder is 9. So when you divide 9 with 9, you are getting 1. Quotient is 1. Remainder is 0. So remainder is 0. Quotient is 1. Already 3 quotient is there. 1 more quotient. So 3 plus 1, 4. Quotient will become 4. Remainder will be 0. Yes or no? Understand or not? If you understand, say yes. If you understand, say yes. Yes, Chirag, you understand. Now take example, solve it at your end. 24, it is easy for you, but you should try for the Nikhilam division. Divide it. Do it. Hurry up. Let me try this. 24. Correct? So, what you will do? No, it will be more example. It is a smaller example. You can take here value 6. 2, 4, 6. This is a very small example. You can extend because here it is very easy 24 to 9. So you will divide. See, divide with 9. Only one digit is here. Now, complement is 1. 1 multiply 2. 2 you will put here. Yes, your answer is correct earlier. The previous answer is Nikita, your answer is correct. Now see the other one. 246 divided by 9. So complement is 1. 2 multiply 1 is 2. Now 2 plus 4, 6. 6 multiply 1 is 6. Now when you will add it, you are getting 12. When you will add it, you are getting 12. Now 4 plus 6, 4 plus 2, 6, 26. But your remainder is more than, greater than your divisor. So what I told you, divide 9 with 12. So when you divide 9, very small value here. Very small value. When 9, 12 divide with 12, you will get 3 is a remainder. And 1 will be the quotient. You will write quotient here. Remainder it will be 3 only. 6 plus 1, 7, 27. So 27 will be the quotient and remainder will be the 3. Understand or not? If you understand, say yes. If you understand, say yes. Okay. So student, listen, now I'm going to extend the Nikhilam division. Now I'm going to take, now consider divisor of two or more digit, very useful for you. Two or more digit whose 9 is important, whose last digit is 9, whose last digit is 9. Very interesting. So first question, 113 divided by 89. Thus, what will be the process? See the 113. So student, here you are dividing with 89. So complement of the 89 is, what will be the complement? I want answer. Your answer, what is the complement of 89? Give your message. I will want to see your answer. What will be the complement of 89? Very interesting to see. Complement of 89. I already told you. Complement of 89. Student, any student, complement of 89? No, Nikita, no. 11, yes. Because 89 has the base 100. And 100 minus 89, you are getting 11. 11 is the complement. So you can write here the complement, just for your understanding. Very good. Chirag, compliment. Nidhi Kumar, yes, done. You are a noob, everyone. Simran, compliment is correct. Now you will take two digits for the remainder. You will take two digits for the remainder because here 89 has base 10. You are 20. Two digits. So complement is 11. 11 multiply 1. You will put in the next digit. 11. That's all. Only one digit. So 31, 4, 11, 2. And 1. This is the quotient and this is the remainder. You can check yourself. Understand or not? Understand or not? If you understand, say yes. If you understand, say yes. Very good. Tanya, understand. Other people are not understanding. Yes. Vijay, yes. Anoop, yes. Very good. You can extend this example. Sometime you may get the answer with this method, like 98. Even you can extend for the three digit also. Okay. So you when you will find the division by direct method 2, 3, 4, 2, 98, so what you will do, you have, when you will multiply with 2, you will get 196. And here is 8, you have a 3 and you have a 2, so you can multiply with 3, you will get 294, you are getting 88. So this is the quotient, this is the remainder. Maybe I am getting, how much time you will take, I don't know, it is up to you. So 2, 3, 4, 2, 98, you can try 98 also for many question. There are so many such examples. Okay, so what is the complement of 98? Any student, complement of 98? Complement 2, very good. But student, I will write 02, because it is the 2-digit number, I will write the complement as 02. So you can write here the complement 02. Correct? Very interesting to see this result. Okay, so 2 multiply 02, you are getting 04. You will write here 04. Okay, now very interesting to see next result will be next. See, I'm explaining this is different way. Whenever you want to find out the 98, correct? So you have a 02, correct? 02 not multiply with 2 plus 3, 5. No, 02 multiply with 3, you will get 06. So you will add it, 2 plus 6, 8, 8, 2, 3. This is the quotient, this is the remainder. Once again, what it is only for the 98. You can do any, up to any level. You can take 3-digit number, 4-digit number, 5-digit number, 10-digit number, 100-digit number. You can do like this. Very. I am explaining. 2, its complement is 02. Multiply 02 with the first digit, you are getting 04. You will write here 04. Correct? Now, 02 multiply with next, not with the sum. Let me explain, not with the sum. Multiply 02 with 3. Correct? 02 with 3, you are getting 06. You will write next to the number. Okay? So, 2 plus 6, 8. 4 plus 4, 8. 3 plus 0, 3, 2. So, this is the quotient, this is the remainder. Understand or not? If you understand, say yes. If you understand, say yes. Yes, very good, very good. Just reply me. If you have enjoyed my session, just reply, enjoying. This is the motivation for me, because I have to prepare for you for the next day also. Okay, just write the enjoying. Very good, very good, very good. I am very happy. Very happy. Thank you very much. You can try so many examples, and I will give you this video also. Okay, thank you very much. Bye bye, Tata. See you tomorrow.
Hello, sir.